Quran chapter 33, verses 69 and 70, lesson 2622. Title is So Many Tips. Chapter Al-Ahzaab, the clans. I seek refuge in Allah from Satan, the outcast. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Verse 69. O ye who believe, be not as those who slandered Moses, peace be upon him, but Allah proved his innocence of that which they alleged, and he was well esteemed in Allah's sight. Verse 70. O ye who believe, keep fearing Allah and speak words straight to the point. Commentary. Sketch of circumstances which will happen on the day of resurrection with those who disbelieve in Allah Almighty in this world has been drawn in the verses mentioned earlier. There will be no limit of their regret and repentance. They will curse very severely to those who were their chiefs and leaders during their worldly life, that they misled them astray from the right straight path. After that, it has been instructed to the believers in this verse, you should not misbehave with your messenger, grace, glory, blessings, and peace be upon him, as the children of Israel did with Moses, peace be upon him. They afflicted him in various ways, charged and accused him falsely, but Moses, peace be upon him, was saved because he was well honored and esteemed in the sight of Allah Almighty. It was proved that he was innocent, but they spoiled their future, who troubled him. Then it is commanded, it is your first work to do after becoming a believer that you should try to save yourselves from the anger of Allah Almighty. You should keep yourselves away from wrong deeds due to fear of Allah Almighty. Speak always words of appropriate justice, whatever and whenever you speak. Truth and honesty is attained by them who fear Allah Almighty and obey the sayings of His Messenger, grace, glory, blessings, and peace be upon Him. It is called abstinence. The person who does not fear Allah Almighty cannot be a guide and leader of others. Urdu mein samaat farmaiye. Unwaan hai besh bahar nasihatein. A'udhu billahi minash-Shay-taanir-Rajiim. Bis-Millaahir-Rah-maanir-Rahiim. Yaaa ayyuhallaziina aamanuu la takuunuu kallaziina aazaw Muusaa fabarra a-hUllaahu mim-maa qaaluu wa kaana indAllaahi Wajiihaa. Yaaa ayyuhallaziina aamanuu takuunuu qaaluu sadeeda. Ey iman walo, tum un jaise mat bano jinhone Muusaa alaihi salam ko sataya phir Allah ne use unke tamam ilzaamat se bari kar diya aur woh Allah ke haan aabroo wala tha. Ey iman walo, Allah se darte raho aur seedhi baat kaho. Allah subhanahu wa taala ka duniya mein inkaar karne walon ka qiyamah ke din jo hashr hoga uska khaka pehli aayat mein khind kar rakh diya gaya hai. Us din unki hasrat aur nadamat ki koi intiha na hogi. Mayusi ki halat mein woh apne duniya ke peshwaon aur qaidon ko buri tarah kosenge ke unhone unko seedhe raaste se hata kar tere raaste par dala tha. Iske baad is aayat mein imaan walon ko aam hidayat ki jati hai कि अपने रसूल सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के साथ ऐसा बर्ताव ना करो जैसा बनी इसराइल ने हजरत मूसा अलैहिस्सलाम के साथ किया था. उन्होंने उन्हें तरह तरह की अजीतें पहुँचाईं, झूठे इल्जाम लगाए, बेसरपा तोहमतें उनके साथ थोपी. इससे हजरत मूसा अलैहिस्सलाम का तो कुछ ना बिगड़ा, क्योंकि वो अल्लाह सुबहाना व तआला के नज़दीक आबरूदार और माजज़ हैं. उसने हजरत मूसा अलैहिस्सलाम का बेखता और बेऐब होना सब पर साबित कर दिया. लेकिन सताने वालों ने अपनी आकबत खराब कर ली. आगे इरशाद है कि ईमान लाने के बाद तुम्हारा काम यह है कि अल्लाह सुबहाना व तआला के गज़ब से बचने की कोशिश करते रहो, उसके डर की वजह से बुरी बातों से अपने आप को दूर रखो, और मुंह से जो बात निकालो वो सच्ची होनी चाहिए. सच्चाई और दयानतदारी उन्हीं को हासिल होती है जो अल्लाह सुबहानहू व तआला से डरते हैं और रसूलुल्लाह सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के कहने पर डरते हैं. इसी को तकवा कहते हैं. और जिसे तकवा हासिल नहीं वो औरों का कायद और रहनुमा नहीं हो सकता. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمي الكريم.